Hi guys, today we will discuss about emergency pharmacotherapy of asthma or a severe acute episode of asthma. How a patient presents and what all you have to do in severe acute asthma. Okay, what will first a brief review of how asthma develops. What is asthma basically? What happens? Asthma actually is a disease of not upper respiratory tract. Upper respiratory tract is still larynx. After larynx, it is a disease of not trachea, not upper respiratory tracheobronchial. It is basically a disease of bronchi, especially the lower bronchi, not alveoli. So it is basically a disease of bronchi, and that too of mucosa of the bronchi. What happens? What are the four components of asthma, a patient having asthma, and when it asthma becomes progress and it causes persistent changes, it goes to a disease known as COPD, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. So first and foremost thing for asthma is that what does actually asthma mean? पहले हम लोग इस asthma को भी it was known as दमा, और दमा को हम लोग बहुत ही stigma के रूप में society stigma के रूप में मानते थे. So it is not a stigma, it is a disease scenario which is ranging from allergy of skin, any type of allergy of skin, जिसको हम लोग we can call it atopy. And from atopy, it ranges, the whole spectrum ranges to COPD. So the march starts from atopy and it ranges from atopy to COPD. So what all develops in between, it is now all termed as asthma. पहले हम लोग asthma इसको नहीं बोलते थे, now it is totally termed as asthma or hyperactive airway disease. So the first and foremost thing is hypersensitive airways. Hypersensitive airways. What are hypersensitive airways? What is hypersensitivity or what is allergy? If you really want to look into it, you should know about it. That when you cause a matchstick and burn it and drop it on the floor, it will extinguish on its own, अपने आप को बुझ जाएगी, okay? लेकिन अगर उसी matchstick को आप petrol bomb में डाल दें तो क्या होगा? बहुत बड़ी आग लग जाएगी, right? So that is hypersensitivity reaction. Allergy is when you are hating anyone. Whenever he comes in front of you, you become red with anger. That is allergy. And what is hyperallergy or hypersensitivity reaction? When you really become angry, and in spite of giving him abusive language or in spite of hitting him, you straight away take out a revolver and shoot him. That is hypersensitivity reaction, right? So allergy, right from allergy to hypersensitivity reaction to COPD. Everything is asthma. So it starts with hypersensitive airways. The airways are hypersensitive. They are pre-designed. They have been sensitized by your immune system. And any allergen which will come inside, it will now produce a hypersensitivity reaction, which is mostly of type 2 hypersensitivity reactions. Okay? Then, then after hypersensitivity reaction, there is hypersensitivity. What will happen? The first thing what will happen is increased mucosal edema. There will be increased mucosal edema. There will be edematous mucosa all over the bronchi, the mucosa will become edematous, right? It will edematous. This is the bronchi. This is mucosa, and now what happens? This mucosa becomes like this. This is edematous mucosa. Now edematous mucosa will be, first thing edematous mucosa will be doing is, it will be constricting the lumen of the bronchi. Okay, the lumen of the bronchi will be obstructed. Third, possible. Okay, now the third thing after mucosal edema will be, there will be contraction of the smooth muscles. Here is the smooth muscles which are lying in the submucosal layer of the airways, right? These are the smooth muscles. Can you tell me what are the receptors which are present in these smooth muscles of the airways? Anyone? Yes, they are basically beta 2 receptors which are present. Beta 2 receptors are present. These beta 2 receptors, basically, they are responsible for bronchoconstriction, right? They will cause, muscarinic receptors are present. Muscarinic receptors will cause bronchoconstriction, and beta 2 receptors are present which will cause bronchodilation, right? So muscarinic receptors will cause bronchoconstriction. So there will be bronchoconstriction because of contraction of the smooth muscles caused by parasympathetic system. There will be bronchoconstriction. So N2 receptors will cause bronchoconstriction. And when you will stimulate beta 2 receptors, it will cause bronchodilation. Then, fourth is increased secretions. Increased secretions. What will increased secretion mean? Whenever there will be, like running nose, whenever you go to a place where you have pollens which are allergic, you are allergic to it, or when you smell a flower, or when you smell a obnoxious smell like heat spray, I usually get obnoxious feeling after getting a heat spray, my nose starts running, right? So there is, I am allergic to these insecticides, okay? So there will be increased secretions. The body will try to push off all the allergens which are stuck on the nasal mucosa by giving increased secretions. So there is always an immune response. It will cause, protectively it will cause secretions, but here, because bronchi are involved, and these bronchi will, there will be increased secretions. These secretions will be collected inside the bronchi because now bronchi are constricted. There is bronchoconstriction. So these secretions will be now tagged. They will be trapped inside this bronchi, constricted bronchi. And these secretions, when they will be trapped inside the bronchi, they will lose water and will become tenacious. Bahut thick sputum type ke tenacious, जिसको हम लोग बोलते हैं गाढ़ा बलगम, वो गाढ़ा बलगम इकट्ठा हो जाता है सांस की नली में, राइट? एंड दिस थिक सिक्रीशन विल फर्दर ब्लॉक द ब्रोंकाई. एक तो करेला ऊपर से नीचे चढ़ा, एक तो म्यूकोसा इडिमा हो गया, सेकेंडली मसल्स कॉन्ट्रैक्ट हो गए, थर्डली देयर विल बी इंक्रीज सिक्रीशंस. तो ये तीनों चीजें मिलकर इतना सीवियर ब्रोंकोकॉन्स्ट्रिक्शन करती है. ऐसा लगता है पेशेंट बोलता है आकर कि मेरे छाती पे ऐसा लगता है जैसे हाथी बैठ गया, as if an elephant is riding on my chest, right? So this will cause, increased secretions will cause, these three things will cause respiratory distress. Fifth is अब बहुत दिनों तक ये होता रहेगा होता रहेगा होता रहेगा. सपोज आई मेक एन इंसिजन ऑन दिस स्किन, ओके दिस स्किन आई मेक एन इंसिजन, ओके एंड लेट इट हील ऑन इटसेल्फ. व्हाट विल हैपन? इट विल हील ऑन इटसेल्फ एंड दिस थंब विल कम नियरर टू दिस फिंगर. आफ्टर इट हील्स अगेन यू मेक एन इंसिजन. व्हाट विल हैपन? इट विल अगेन हील एंड दिस फर्दर फाइब्रोसिस विल बी देयर एंड विल कॉज फर्दर कमिंग. A day will come when you keep on incising the skin. A day will come that this thumb and this finger will be stuck together. There will be complete fibrosis. So repeated attacks are causing, recurrent attacks are causing some amount of fibrosis, some amount of repair, and they are causing permanent remodeling of the airways. So there will be remodeling of the airways. अब जो ये एयरवेज थी, दिस एयरवेज विल बी द एयरवेज ऑफ लाइक दिस. नाउ द एयरवेज विल बी एलांगा. दिस विल बी द एयरवेज. देयर विल बी रीमॉडलिंग ऑफ द एयरवेज. द ब्रोंकाई व्हिच वर स्ट्रेट और स्मूथ, they will be not tortuous and they will be remodeled, right? And this is this condition which is known as chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. This is COPD. You have seen very old age people which are now, these days they are suffering with corona or any type of other respiratory infections. I will not be able to speak. Okay, they are not able to speak even because permanently at rest also they have got dyspnea, they have got respiratory distress because of there is thickened airways. Okay, so now you have usually that how you can understand that how you can tailor your target your therapeutics according to these changes right from allergy to changes to remodeling. Now you have to learn how to address this. So shortly I will discuss that how we will address it. First of all, you must understand this basic pathogenesis. If you not understand this basic pathogenesis, you are not going to treat this condition. So for hypersensitivity, you have to combat allergy. So all the anti-allergic drugs which are attacking the immune system, they will be directed towards this. This is the first pharmacotherapy, therapeutic target on which you will attack. Okay? So all the drugs which are anti-allergic, which are going to decrease the hypersensitivity, decrease the petrol pump to a simple floor, on which whenever you will give a trigger like matchstick, it will extinguish by itself. It will not cause further damage. So all the drugs which are anti-allergic, they are known as preventers. Preventers. Okay? These are preventer drugs. This is causing a problem right now. It's quite social distancing. There is no need for mask. So they are preventive drugs. Okay. Then drugs which will decrease the mucosal edema or which will decrease the bronchial secretions, they will be anti-inflammatory drugs. Right? They will be anti-inflammatory drugs, and the drugs which will relax the pathways, they will be known as bronchodilators. Right? They will be known as bronchodilators. So anti-inflammatory drugs which will cause decrease in mucosal edema, decrease in bronchial secretions, they will be known as anti-inflammatory and mucolytic drugs. Antibiotic drugs cause increased secretions, as well as mucolytic drugs. What will they do? Mucolytic drugs will decrease the tenacity of the secretions. It will cause secretions to become very thin. Okay, so then thin secretions can be easily passed out from the respiratory tract. So antibiotic drugs and mucolytic drugs, along with bronchodilators, they are categorized under the common head of relievers. Relievers. So preventers and relievers will cure your asthma completely. It will not further cause further attacks. Number one, if there is an attack, it will cause emergency relief. And permanent prevention along with relievers is the only means of treatment to prevent COPD. So COPD is a condition which is preventable only when you take care of 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay? So in next lecture we will be dealing with anti-allergic, anti-inflammatory and mucolytics and bronchodilators or relievers. So what are the preventers and relievers and how you give it, we will be compiling in our next clip of asthma part 2. Thank you. Concept, reading your books, reading videos, reading all these things, and then we will come up to the therapeutics of what the condition we are having. Thank you. Bye.